Look what we got on our Twitter timeline last night. That's a tweet directly from Oracle SQL developer. And the credit for this goes to you, my lovely audience, as without your support, this would not have been possible. Do check out this tweet on your Twitter and don't forget to hit that favorite button. What's up, internet? I am Manish from RebellionRider.com and I am back once again with another short and crispy PL SQL tutorial. This tutorial will be about first collection method, which is count. I think calling this tutorial short won't be right. But anyways, I will try to keep it under 10 minutes. Before we start the tutorial, let me take a quick second to ask you to subscribe if you haven't already. Also, make sure to smash that thumbs up button and like the video. Let's aim for 100 likes. See if we can reach 100 likes on this video in a week. That being said, without taking much of your time, let's start the tutorial. Collection method count returns the number of elements in an initialized collection. If used with an initialized collection with no elements, it returns 0. In case of nested table, collection method count only returns the number of non-empty elements, as it is possible for a nested table to have individual elements that are empty. Let's write some code and see how we can use this collection method. That is the same nested table which we created in PL SQL tutorial 51 on how to create nested table in PL SQL block. As you can see here, after creating the nested table, we initialized it and inserted 10 elements into it. Which means this nested table has 10 elements in it. Now, let's try to get this information using the collection method count. On execution, we will get the total number of elements stored into our nested table. Let's execute and see. Here is the result, which is 10. Similarly, you can use the count method with if condition. Let's see how. But before that, let's close this script output and delete this section. That is how you can use count method with if condition. But most commonly, we use count method with loop to cycle through the collection, like this. Here we use collection method count in the loop statement. Using the function count, we are making sure that our loop executes from 1 to the total number of elements we have in our collection, which will be returned by this function. This collection method count dynamically assigns the total number of elements that we have into the collection. Imagine if we don't have this collection method. We will first have to count the total number of elements manually and then write them down into our code. Also, keep the code updated every time someone inserts or deletes an element from the collection. It is easy when the collection is small. But what if we have a huge collection of, say, several thousand elements? Then this will become a pain in the ass. Anyways, these are few of the ways of using count method. Now let your creativity fly and find out various other ways to use this function. If you find something new, then comment down below and let me know. Meanwhile, give this video a thumbs up. Also, by sharing this tutorial, you can help others in learning and our channel in growing. This is the tutorial on collection method count in Oracle database. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.